Okay, part two. We're pretty much at the end of the fast road, although there is a small section ahead of us. We were stopped at traffic lights, so I was able to hit the button again. The other thing about this is imports. In particular, food, and what that would mean. Pretty much as a country, we haven't been self-sufficient for quite some time. A chunk of our food is imports and is imported from Europe. Obviously, we have things imported from other countries, and it's confused a degree because some of the exotic fruits and vegetables are actually grown here. A number of the other exotic animals are also bred here as well. So it's it's not easy to... Even the bananas. I think, the Cavendish banana? I don't know, but if you look up the history of the bananas, you'll find that there's a good portion of the bananas in Africa, wherever, etc., in various territories, that actually trace their lineage back to a strain of the banana that was actually cultivated in the UK, and that then went out. I think it was something to do with resistance to various diseases that affect the bananas, although even that situation has changed. But the banana is a good, if you look at the history, it's pretty it's a pretty good indicator of how global the world has become, and even became many decades, if not centuries ago. So all this stuff about being isolationist, duh. But one thing that does mean is that, you know, a chunk of our food is imported from Europe. There was all the fish and chip malarkey that was going on. Yeah, a particular fish and chip shop was sourcing its fish locally, but its potatoes for the chips came from elsewhere in Europe. Being part of the EU helps us to be resilient to crop failure. I mean, we do have crop failure. We get it. It happens, particularly in the drier months here. Typically during that time, you will, when those have happened, if you can recall them, the prices of some foods have gone up. And indeed, some of the strains have changed because we haven't had the strains that have been normally grown in this country because they've failed. But even on that side of things, prices went up, even though a lot of the core foods that we eat were sourced from elsewhere within Europe. And if we're outside Europe, those prices, if you thought they rose high then, they're going to rise even higher still now. We don't really have the landmass to support the population that we have now. And I immediately know what the right wing are going to say. They're going to say, well, if we boot everyone out, then we will have the capacity to feed ourselves. Actually, no, even then we won't. And even if we do that, what do we do in the event of crop failure? So we'll get a double whammy. We'll potentially lose production. We don't know how much. And we'll potentially lose business because the taxes on our exports to Europe. Again, we don't really know how much, because a lot of it will depend on the European consumer. Will they still buy British goods? And if the attitude from within the EU, by the very action, you know, some people will buy politically, some will buy quality, some, you know, there will be people who buy and don't buy for different reasons. So there's no way for us to call it. And also then we'll be facing taxes on the imports, which will probably hit us most strongly in the arena of food. And, you know, it's going to be tough enough. It will be quite tough. We're not talking masses of money, but it will certainly stretch the household budgets, which are already stretched. It will break some of them, for sure. I mean, when you look at the amount of our population that's already reliant on food banks, you know? And we also have access to and participate in the food mountains. We'd lose that. Or it would come at a cost. Yeah. To me, it's just unsustainable coming out. It's just, yeah, very patriotic, but a patriotic illusion. And it would put us in such a worse position financially from a number of different fronts. And those who are already struggling would be stretched to even further. It would just be bananas. Bananas. Yeah. And if you watch the Jeremy Paxman program, that even explains the banana issue. It's all thoroughly bent. See you later. Bye for now.